has officially been a few weeks since the NHL's trade deadline, so we thought it might be appropriate to take a look at how some of these new players and new places are doing. Let's start with someone that you talked a lot about leading up to the deadline, Ege, Kevin Hayes.
Yeah, Kevin Hayes was someone we knew he was going to be traded because the Rangers are in a rebuild and they weren't really making any effort to re-sign him. And you can see since then, not bad, 3-3. I think he needs some time to fit. That's a dramatic change, I think, to go from the New York Rangers to the Winnipeg Jets. And I think he needs probably a little time to get settled there.
Yeah, he had a three-point effort in one game I saw at home. And I think him and Nikolaj Ehlers have had some connection together, so it's good. I mean, this is a guy who, you know, just under a point per game since he got there. He's playing big minutes, overall big minutes. I think he can help on the PK. I think he's probably gaining the trust of the coaching staff, too, and realizing, all right, how valuable is this guy? And you can see he can do it offensively and defensively. And I think it'll be a great, great fit. If they go far, he'll play a huge role.
Yeah.
All right. To one of the bigger fish, the biggest fish, I guess, at the deadline, Mark Stone.
Yeah.
Living it up in Vegas.
Yeah. It's gone well. I mean, since he's been there, look at the numbers, 6-1. They had the band waiting for him at the airport.
For a team that was struggling, sort of, heading into the deadline.
Yeah, they were looking for some help, and they were looking to change things up exactly. And now they've got two lines that they can really kind of count on. And you can see here, he's got 2 goals, 5 points. The numbers are good. He's playing significant minutes. He plays in all situations. Yeah. He looks like he's been a really perfect fit.
He does.
And maybe he's just one of those players that would be a perfect fit
for
pretty
anyone.
Much anywhere because he has a complete game.
Yeah. Well, I think that anytime you add a guy who immediately becomes your leading scorer, it's nice to be able to look at him and say, this is going to be a guy big offensively for us. So huge extension with them. I think there's great things to come in for him.
Wouldn't it be crazy if Vegas went to the Cup Final again?
It could happen.
Yep. First 2 years in existence.
They got the best goalie in the conference.
I'm just saying, I'm getting way ahead of myself, but like that would be crazy.
Yes.
Yeah.
To think an expansion team.
And it would be really, really tough on the people in television.
That would have to go.
Suffer.
Ugh.
And travel all the way to Las Vegas. Yeah.
Off of your bank account.
Yeah, that'd be tough.
It wasn't tough on mine last year. I'll tell you that. I went home up. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. I went home with over 500 extra.
Wow.
Nothing matters, but
not so much.
I need my lucky charm, Ege. Ege was with me the whole way.
We had it rolling.
All right. Mark Stone's former teammate, Matt Duchene, also on the move at the deadline. We've talked a lot about the Blue Jackets in this show. What do you make of Duchene?
Well, I think as of right now, it hasn't gone great. I think there's been games when he's looked fabulous, but we saw just 4 points and 1 goal in the 10 games he has played, and they're 5-5. So I think that you're just looking for more offense out of the entire team. You can't rely on just Matt Duchene to be the guy who's putting up all the points. But I think him and Panarin and Dzingel and all these guys that are up front there that aren't putting the puck in the net these last 6 games especially, they got to figure out what's going on. So he comes over with a teammate in Dzingel, which really helps out. But at the same time, when the team's off 500 since you've been there, you're kind of feeling like, we got to take that next step, and I want to be a part of it. I know I was brought in here for a reason. And sometimes mentally that can mess with the guy a little bit. But there's probably a little bit more for him to give, along with the entire roster in Columbus right now.
Yeah, you know, it's funny because we talked about Kevin Hayes, right? He goes to Winnipeg. Winnipeg's not missing the playoffs, right? There's no, like, they may finish first, they may finish second, but they're in the Western Conference. They're going to the playoffs. They have no issues. So Kevin Hayes can kind of get settled.
True.
And no pressure. Matt Duchene, I mean, they've got to win in Columbus right now, and they've got to continue to win because it's going to take probably a record number of points just to get the 8th spot in the Eastern Conference. So that's some end. You're a free agent at the end of the year. Your value is going to go up and down. Got to be a tough spot for Matt.
I also think that, you know, right now, 4 points in 10 games, people are upset if they're a fan. Well, this is a guy who can go get 3-4 points
That's
in a
right.
game, and all of a sudden
exactly.
he's got 8. So it could change quickly for him and the entire team.
Time will tell. Elsewhere, Wayne Simmonds now in Nashville.
Yeah, this is kind of an interesting one. I mean, David Poyer was looking to create this kind of stuff right here. Physical play, which he's getting, a net front type of presence getting into the mix in front. And, Wayne Simmonds is going to do all the things that he's always done. That's who he is as a player. The Preds, it hasn't been. We haven't seen it necessarily on the in their record so far. But I think Wayne Simmons is going to give them exactly what they're looking for because that's who he is. That's what he plays that way all the time.
Yeah, and they know what they're going to get effort-wise. I think they know in front of the net if anyone pushes him, he's going to push you back. He's
that's
willing
right.
to fight. Doesn't have a goal yet, but those will come, especially if they go on a little bit of run. It's the same way with Kevin Hayes. I mean, if they go on a run in the spring, he'll have something to do with
yes,
it. He'll be
will.
In front of the net on the power play. He'll be getting pucks out, doing the little things that he's always done, like you said. So Nashville 2-3 with him, so you've seen a little bit of struggles, and I think overall they got to play better as a team. But they made a lot of moves. So, you know, they brought Boyle in. They made some other changes. It takes a little time.
Granlund as well. Yep. So.
All right, we got time for one more.
Okay.
Let's talk Ryan Donato, because he seems like a good fit with the Wild.
Yeah, I mean, you know what? He spent time up and down. He was in the minors this year. The Bruins didn't feel like he was playing well enough defensively to have a regular spot on the top line. And since getting to the Wild, he's lit it up. I mean, he's made an immediate impact. You see Charlie Coyle came over, and Donato's been there. He scored a couple big goals, and I think that his skill's evident. The question was, how is he defensively? But in 10 games, just under a point per game, playing 15 minutes, 16 minutes close to, you've seen that there is a guy here who could score, who'll be able to produce offensively in this league. And by giving him a chance and giving him more ice time, he's probably thrilled.
Yeah, I'm sure he is really thrilled. He's getting opportunity,
yes.
which he wasn't necessarily getting with the Boston Bruins. They're loaded with some talented players there. Minnesota, a fresh start. Been really good so far for the Wild. We'll see if he can continue to put up those kind of numbers because they've been pretty good.
It's funny how often we see, right, like just being in a place that can give you the opportunity that you need to sort of thrive. It wasn't there in Boston because they're a very good team. They've got a lot of depth, but the Minnesota Wild will take it.